All right, you guys, welcome back to the Reverse Selling Podcast. With me, I've got my partner in crime. Somebody calls him Robin. I call him Colton. What's up, Mr. Fisher?
What's happening, B? How you doing?
I'm doing well. I love the new setup at your house. It looks really, really good.
Thanks, bro.
And you got the new camera going and all that. That's really good.
Yes, sir.
So I think today is going to be, I believe, one of the most valuable episodes that you and I ever do. And I know that's a huge promise to the audience. And the reason I say that, Colton, is because we are going to teach everybody watching this, either listening to this on the podcast or watching the replay on YouTube. We're going to teach real estate agents how to create a communication strategy that positions themselves as irresistible, where sellers won't be able to reject them when they ask for a listing appointment. What do you think about that?
I think that when you and I were talking before, now I've heard you say a lot of really good things, and people all the time on our coaching calls say, Brandon, you just have a way of explaining things that it just doesn't, I don't even understand how you do it. And when we were talking before, what you've done in the past is nothing compared to what you were telling me that we're about to get into. So I'm excited.
Yeah. And I'm really excited too. And it's a big promise and I think we're going to live up to it, but we won't be the judge because value is in the eye of the beholder. And in this case, it's the audience. So as you guys go through this, essentially, we're going to do a live training today in today's podcast. As you listen to this, as you watch this, as you go through this, I really, really want your feedback. And so underneath this video, let me know if you get it and you'll understand what I mean by get it after we go through this training. So I'm going to share my screen, Colton, and we're going to jump right into it.
Let's do it.
And I really like this format too. I like being in the studio, but I like this format with you as well.
Yeah, it's fun to mix it up.
Yeah, yeah, exactly right. So let me just make sure you can see. Can you see my screen?
Yeah, I got it perfectly.
It's crispy and clear?
Yep.
All right. So we're talking about how to get prospects to agree to give you, the real estate agent, an opportunity to earn their business. That's what we're talking about today. And so the first thing that we need to do in order to make that happen is, Colton, we have to teach the audience how to create what we call an irresistible advancement. And an advancement is essentially getting the prospect to agree to the next step in the sales process. For us in real estate, that means, that could mean a phone call, that could mean a Zoom meeting, that could be an in-person meeting, but that's what an advancement would be. In other businesses, it could mean something different, but in our world of real estate sales, that's what an advancement means. Make sense so far?
Yeah.
All right. So in order to do that, in order for an advancement to take place, it requires the prospect to agree to the action, right? Because if we want to set up a phone call or a meeting, the prospect has to agree to that action, right? So the first thing we have to understand is Newton's law of motion. And what he said was this. He said, an object at rest will stay at rest. An object in motion will stay in motion unless acted upon by an unbalanced force, aka your irresistible advancement. So what we're talking about here, when we look at Newton's law, is a prospect, when we reach out to them, they're at rest and they're going to stay at rest, right? They're not going to call us to meet with us. Would you agree with that, Colton?
Yeah, 100%.
Like, they're not calling you out of the blue. A for sale by owner, an expired listing, is not calling you out of the blue to set a listing appointment. That's what you all want. That's what you all thought you were going to have when you got into this business of real estate. But the reality is it's not happening. So that object, in this case, a seller, is going to stay at rest unless, to Newton's point, they're acting upon an unbalanced force. We have to create that unbalanced force, which I call an irresistible advancement. Any clarity that you think I need to add there?
No, I think the next couple parts will make it clear.
All right, perfect. So let's talk about, how do we create an irresistible advancement? So your IA, or your irresistible advancement, has to have three components to get that prospect to agree to the meeting. One, it must have curiosity. It must have perceived value, and it must bring the prospect closer to their desired outcome. So in order to do that, the first thing we have to do is create the WIFM if the seller agrees to that advancement. And the WIFM is what's in it for me. Like, why would a seller agree to the advancement? And in this case, we're talking about a listing appointment, just so we don't lose the audience. And they're like, what the hell are they guys talking about? That's the advancement, right? We're talking to them over Instagram Messenger. We're talking to them over a phone call. We're talking to a divorce attorney at a networking meeting. We're talking about how do we take a prospect from that point in time and get them to meet with us? That is an advancement. So why would the person, what's in it for the prospect to accept the meeting? So we have to create that. So when we look at that seller, when we look at that, Colton, for a referral partner, or in this case, a seller to agree to a listing appointment, what are some things that a seller would get from meeting with a realtor at a listing appointment? And I have a few examples that are on screen. And I want to see, Colton, if you want to add any. So the seller would get a price analysis. They would find out how much their house would sell for in a meeting. They would potentially get a marketing plan from a real estate agent on how that realtor is going to sell their house. They're going to get a seller net analysis. So they can say, okay, I know how much my house is going to sell for. How much am I going to walk away with? And then the fourth example I had on here was the seller will also determine if you're the agent to help them with their desired outcome, which is getting their home sold. These are four things that a seller gets when they meet with a realtor. Like, that's what's in it for the seller. But those are pretty boring things. We're going to talk about how do we position those things to be sexy. What are some other things, Colton, that a seller might get from meeting with an agent?
One other might be, especially with the way the market is right now, kind of just a strategy of like how they should move, right? Like, you got to buy a house, you got to sell a house, you're moving your job across the country. Like, how should we do this where you don't get in a bad position and lose a ton of money?
That's a great one. So the structuring the move.
Yeah.
And then structuring the sale, timing, all of those things. Yeah, it's a great point.
And preventing them from doing something silly. Like, don't spend $20,000 on that kitchen right now. It's not going to make you any more money. Like, don't do things that are going to lose you money.
All right. So these are all good examples. And so for you guys watching or listening to this, this is step one. You want to get a list of everything a seller would get from you if they said, yes, I'll meet with you. I'll give you the opportunity to list my house. We got to create the list. Okay. This is the WIFM. The next thing we do, Colton, is we want to create what I call a trailer script that gives the prospect a compelling reason to say yes to the advancement. Okay, that's what we have to do. So we have to take what would be perceived by the seller as low value or boring and turn it into something sexy that the prospect cannot resist. Even if they wanted to, they can't. So here's an example of like boring and what most of the like most real estate agents do. Maybe some of you watching or listening to this, maybe this is what you do. Okay. You will say something and you probably heard this script 1,000 times. Mr. Prospect, let's meet so I can show you how I get home sold and try to sell you on listing your home with me. Boring. Like, that's what realtors say. Of course, Colton. The realtors can't get sellers to meet with them. Of course, their contact to listing appointment set ratio is absolutely terrible because the message in which we're delivering is not compelling. It doesn't pique curiosity. It doesn't bring the prospect closer to their desired outcome. This is the problem. So we have to change that. And this is what I just talked about. This does not create what Newton describes as an unbalanced force, which is why agents have so many prospects rejecting them when they ask for an appointment. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So what we have to do for all of you listening or watching this is you have to remember your IA, okay, your irresistible advancement must have all three components to increase the likelihood of the prospect agreeing. Has to have curiosity. It has to have perceived value for them. and it has to bring the prospect closer to their desired outcome. The script, Colton, that all these realtors are using is all about them. It's all self-serving. It's all about, what can I do? What can I say so I get the listing? There's no value for the prospect. Thus, the prospect says, no, I don't want to meet with you. No, I'm not interested. Then the agent starts to try to overcome the objection with like high pressure selling tactics. How well is that working? Oh yeah, that's right. It doesn't. So what we have to do is we have to create our trailer script. Okay. So an example, the best example I can give the audience, Colton, is what movie trailers do. They take the most exciting parts of a movie without giving away too much of the plot. This creates intrigue, curiosity, and an emotion with the viewer to get them to watch the movie, regardless if the movie sucks or not. Okay. This is what movie trailers do a really, really, really good example of. And I want to give the audience an example right now. This has been the trailer I'm about to show is the has been rated the best movie trailer of all time. And I bet you the audience, you guys tell me in the comments section, I bet you none of you have even watched this movie. Are you ready, Colton?
I'm excited. Let's see it.
Dude, did you see that? Did you hear all that?
Yep.
I don't care. That movie was made before both you and I were born. And it doesn't, first off, you've probably never seen Alien, I would imagine, right?
Of course I have.
Oh, you have?
Oh, I have that, Predator. Come on, man. Those are classics.
Here's the thing. It's like, what words did they use? Zero.
Right.
They didn't say anything. They said nothing. Would you agree?
Oh, yeah. Not a thing.
Not a thing. And it's like, it doesn't matter if you're into sci-fi movies or not. I watched that for the first time and in preparation for this training. And I'm like, all right. So I start Googling the best trailers of all time. And I started watching it, right? In the beginning, I'm like, this is the best trailer. But then it kept going, right? The music and the what you were seeing visually. And then by the end, it was like, I have to see this movie. This is insane what I'm showing, like what they're showing. Like it did all three of the things that we're talking about. I was so curious. I was so intrigued. It created this world where I'm like, I have to see that movie. I don't care about aliens. I don't care about sci-fi movies. I don't care about any of those things. And then at the end where everything goes silent and it says, no one in space can hear you scream. It's like, dude, I have to watch it. And lo and behold, that movie is one of the most successful movies of all time.
Hmm.
And the point here is how they package that. So let me share my screen. You want to add anything to that?
No, I mean, it goes to another point where, you know, another really famous movie, Ferris Bueller's Day Off. I had never seen it before. I've heard lots about it. And someone said to me, look, you know, that movie is like what we're going through today. There's Ferris and then there's the principal. There's us. And then with everything that's going on with this pandemic, and I was just that little bit, I was like, all right, I got to watch it. Like, what are they talking about? That little bit of intrigue, I got to see it.
Yeah. And that's what we're talking about is like, how can you communicate with a potential client or a seller prospect in a way where they just can't resist? They have to meet with you. And the problem is most realtors, what they're saying, what they're communicating, what they're sending to prospects is boring. It's not sexy. It doesn't compel anybody to take any action. So a object that is not in motion stays, you know, I don't know how the saying, I'm missing the whole thing. An object at rest stays at rest because you haven't created any reason for someone to take action. So if we take that alien trailer and we say, okay, well, imagine if the trailer was the director on camera, Colton, and they just said, all right, guys, this is a sci-fi movie about aliens. We hope you watch it. Like, if that was the trailer, does that do anything?
Not at all.
Does nothing. But like, this is what realtors do every single day. Okay, Mr. Prospect, well, let's get together and I want an opportunity to sell you on listing your house with me. Dude, that doesn't do anything. That doesn't create a compelling reason for sellers to say yes. Would you agree?
Yeah, exactly.
So what we have to do in order to make all this come to fruition is we have to craft our trailer script around what a seller would get at the listing appointment. So we don't say things like, Mr. Seller, I'd like to come over and present to you a price analysis. Boring, not going to take any action. It doesn't create intrigue. Okay. We have to take the same information. We got to take the best parts of our movie, which our movie in this case is what? It's the listing appointment, right? So we have to look at two things. We have to look at what the seller's desired outcome is. And then we have to say, how does meeting or having a phone call with me help the seller accomplish their desired outcome? Every seller's desired outcome is to sell their home for a premium because they believe their home is better than any other home, right? And all the time that we've worked with sellers, there's no sellers that don't think that. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, exactly.
It's like every seller, every FSBO, everybody thinks that their house is worth more than everybody's. It's what they want. That is their desired outcome, right? So how can we communicate the WIFM, going back a couple slides in the training, that would compel the seller to watch our movie? And again, Colton, what's our movie?
The listing presentation.
It's the listing presentation. What can we say? What can we do to create a world in the eyes of the prospect that is so irresistible that compels them to say, I have to meet with this person. I have to meet with this person. Whether I'm ready to hire them or not, whether I wanted to watch the movie or not, I can't help it. I have to meet with them. The answer is creating their trailer script in their irresistible advancement. Okay. So let's give everybody an example. Hopefully you guys are with us because once you understand this, I believe, Colton, the audience will change what they do, how they do it, what they say, how they say what they say for the rest of their career. So here's an example. Instead of using the old script, I'm going to take it back off screen, give you guys a little hint. Boom, boom, boom. Look at that. There's some intrigue. That's the point. I put it on screen. I take it away. It makes you want to watch it even more. Hopefully they're with me, Colton. Hopefully they're really getting this. Like
they're
pretty
smart people in our crowd. I think they're with us.
All right, good. So instead of saying something boring that doesn't entice people to take action, and Colton, you're probably like, are you like, let me see the script?
I'm on the edge of my seat, man.
Come on. I hope that's working. That was kind of the point of today's training. But here's an example. Mrs. Seller, here's what might make sense. And really, I don't mind. Why don't we schedule some time to get together this week? I'll share a plan that will cause buyers to overpay for your home. And then after our meeting, you can decide if working with me makes any sense or not. Does that seem reasonable? Right? So what I'm trying to do is create a meeting based around a plan to get the seller what they want, which is getting a buyer to overpay for their house. Because let's face it, Mrs. Seller, your house is better than every other house out there. Would you agree? Yes, Brandon, it's the best. So why are we not packaging and positioning our trailer script in a way that causes people to say yes? Because here's what I'll bet, Colton, because agents that we coach always ask me the same thing. I pique their curiosity. When I use this script, when I say, I'll share a plan that causes buyers to overpay for your home, what do agents always ask us on our coaching calls?
How would I do that?
How do you do that? Yeah. We did it to it the realtor. Dude, it works on them. This is how you get the seller to say, wow, I'd love to see that freaking plan. Like, guys, this is the point. When you can get the seller to say,
Well, how are you going to do that for me?
How are you going to do that for me? That's exactly why we need to meet. And that is the point of today's training. And that's what I wanted to really help the audience understand. Everyone is so obsessed with like, give me the script. Well, if we go back to the example we gave with the Alien movie trailer, they said no words, nothing was said, but they still got us on an emotional roller coaster. They still created a world of curiosity and intrigue to make us go to the movie theater. I haven't seen that movie yet, but now I need to see it, especially after you saying you've seen it. You're like, oh yeah, I've seen it. Well, dude, watching that trailer has done what I hope that agents are going to do in their market to get people to watch their movie.
Amazing. It's awesome. And it goes back to, like, I think it's all rooted, and this is a big part of just persuasion in general, of what you'd said earlier with the WIFM, right? Like, it's like an unconscious radio station that's always playing in your head and everyone's head at all times. And so just knowing that and positioning how you're saying things to that is just going to make it a little bit easier.
Yeah. And I just, we talk about this all the time on our coaching calls, but like, I'll share that here. It's like, you're not looking to list the house over a prospecting phone call. Like I'm talking about literally, I'm not like, you can't be on the, you and I can't be on the phone for the first time and I get the listing right now. Something has to occur between those two occurrences. And what it is a listing appointment. Everyone watching this would be like, yeah, that makes sense. So what do we have to do to get that listing appointment? Because that's the thing standing in the way of us getting the listing. Yep. So we have to sell the value of the appointment. That's the key takeaway. The how is creating the irresistible advancement. An advancement in reverse selling is taking a prospect over the phone and getting them to agree to a meeting. That's an advancement. We do that by everything we talked about in today's training. And hopefully you understood the frameworks that we walked through. And you have to craft your message in a way that gets people to take action. That's what you have to do. And we call it the trailer script.
And I think to wrap this up, I want to know your perspective on this. I have a theory that I think reigns true for me in a lot of things, but when it comes to, especially for realtors, the reason why, going back to what you said, all right, well, hold on, first, let's not list the house over the phone. First, we got to get to an appointment. That's where it starts. And I think a big part of the reason why unconsciously realtors can't get to that point is because they're scared. Let's say I set the appointment. What do I do when I'm there? What do I bring? What should I say? How am I going to do what I said I'm going to do? And it's just, they're missing the next couple of steps beyond that. So then they don't learn the skills to get there in the first place. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, that's a really good point. I think that it's not wrong thinking, but I think the way in which you solve that, yes, you can learn and we'll be glad to teach people what to do. But I think the bigger thing here is allowing yourself to go to the appointment and completely fail, completely Ooh. Fall on your face. That's the point. That's why we teach this before we teach the appointment is I want you to learn how to get a lot of appointments. And then I want you to go on these appointments and I want you to fail as much as possible. Not literally, come on, people, like, stay with me. I'm talking about figuratively. What I mean by this is like, when you go there, you're going to be learning what to do, right? Because here's the thing. If I teach you exactly what to do at the appointment and you have no appointments, what good is that?
Yeah.
Right? Yep. So I need, the only way to learn how to ride the bike is to ride the bike, and the figuratively fail is falling and allowing the child to scrape their face without that experience, they never get to learn to ride a bike. Yeah. This is the same thing. So when you're riding the bike and you're wobbling, that's you at the listing appointment falling over. That is what's required first before you figure out what to do at the appointment.
And I think that's some of the magic sauce that you give to our agents of like, we see all these stories, like the last two YouTube videos you've posted before the last, this interview, it's like, wow, like 150,000 in 6 months as a brand new agent. I think, and there's tons more, but I think part of that is because we give people a good balance, right? Like you don't just throw them into the dogs and say, no, I'm not going to tell you what to do. Like go screw it up. It's like,
right.
That's where we're coming from. That's the action we need to take. But here's kind of an idea of what you'd be doing there, but you're not going to know that until you go through it, right? Mike Tyson says, everyone's got a plan until they get punched in the mouth. So it's like,
I love it.
You could get it perfect. You can know every little part. And the first listing appointment you go on, the first prospecting call you make, you're going to feel like an idiot, and that's okay.
That is such a great point because, and you articulated that better than me. It's like teaching somebody, going back to the bike analogy, mm-hmm. could you imagine trying to tell a kid how to balance a bike with them never being on a bike before? It'd be like way out of context. Like, I have no idea what you're talking about. It's not until they actually feel that feeling of balance or unbalance does what you say bring context.
Yep.
So that's what we're saying here. Like for me to teach you what to do and you've never been on an appointment before would be like me trying to teach a kid to balance a bike when they've never touched a bike before.
Right. Yeah.
Telling is not selling. You know what I mean? And it's the same thing with like training and coaching and teaching people things. You have to experience. You have to have some experience for us, for the training to soak in and have context to it. So, dude, great episode. I can't wait to see what you all think. And hopefully this framework puts things in perspective where you're like, wow, now I get. When you talk about skills, Brandon, and increasing my conversion ratio, now I understand what you mean. And most importantly, how. It's not grabbing my scripts, which you guys can download. We'll put a link under this video. It's not grabbing the script and reading it like a book report in fifth grade in front of the class. Okay, Mr. Prospect, line number one. Hi, this is Brandon. That's not going to move the needle. It's how you say what you say that will move the needle.
Yep.
Cool. All right, brother. Awesome episode. We will see you guys again next week. Let us know your thoughts on today's episode or what you thought and what you would like to see from Colton and I moving forward. Appreciate you, Mr. Fisher.
We'll see you guys.